brother was doing a production of Music Man at high school, and they invited me to do Winthrop, Peru. Yeah, because they wanted a kid instead of a high school kid playing it. And so I went to play. I played it, and I realized I was with high school girls, and they'd all think, "You're so cute," and they would hug me. I'd be about breast level, and I go,
"You were sunk."
And I was like, "I'm an actor. I'm going to be an actor for life. This job is good." And I just sort of stayed with it. And I came to New York, went to NYU, and just started. After I got to NYU, I just started hitting the pavement. And luckily enough, I survived as an actor for like 20, 30 years. I don't know how.
It's an accomplishment.
Yeah.
I got my start as an actor basically in college. I did 25 plays in 4 years of college. My first job was Troilus and Troilus and Cressida at Lincoln Center for Joe Papp, about which Clive Barnes, who was the reviewer of the New York Times, said, "The most boring 3 hours in New York City can currently be found at Lincoln Center. They are called Troilus and Cressida." The work is interesting. Yeah. You're doing different parts all the time.
Yeah.
So you're learning different things all the time. Now I'm doing less and less because of the Parkinson's. Acting has changed a lot for me. I noticed early on, before I was diagnosed, that I had a tremor of some kind. My hand would go like this. It was uncontrollable, so it would help if there was a costume that had a big cloak that I could hide it under. You think of your body as being your instrument as an actor instead of a piano for a pianist. It's your body, and the image I give to people is, if you take a stone or a pebble and you throw it into a pool of water, there's a ripple that goes out from it. Well, with me, it's like my body. You take a stone and throw it into my pool of water, and it just goes bloom, like it's in a bed of sand. There's no ripple. What's kind of extraordinary is that people say about my acting these days, it's so economical. You don't do anything. It's so pure. And of course, it's that way because...
Holding on for dear life.
Because that's the only way the toothpaste comes out of the tube. I have no control over it, really.
For me, I was a very physical actor. All my stuff, I'd work out. I loved comedy like Chris does. I loved working out like bits. Yeah, cheap bits. The cheaper the better. So I found that extremely, I became extremely limited as far as being able to physically do things on stage. I would just, bah! And people were going, "Wow. Your acting is so powerful, you don't do anything." I'm just angry, you know. I'm like, all these years, I'm wasting all this energy.
An interesting thing happened to me. The first show that I did after I was diagnosed, when I was on medication, I had a piece of exposition about this long, about a page long, that laid out all the particulars of the plot that were important for the audience to know.
Good choice.
And I got through about two sentences of it. There's only one other actress on stage with me, and I was talking to her, and I went totally sky high. And I looked at her with terror in my eyes as if to say, "Help me, please." I can't remember what to say. And she looked at me with hopelessness in her eyes as if to say, I don't have any lines here.
You're on your own, brother.
So I said, "If I were to say something to you right now, what do you think it might be?" She paused, and then she said her approximation to my next line, and I said, "Right. Then what?" And she fed me my next line. And we somehow got through it, and I didn't die.
I did the same sort of thing that Chris was talking about. When I was doing that Richard II, I started to do Lord Barclay. I did broke into Hamlet's speech in the middle of Lord Barclay, because they were similar, raging rocks and shivering shocks or something like that, you know, Midsummer.
Yeah.
But it was very similar to Shakespeare, Hamlet's speech. I did Hamlet opening night for about four lines, and the whole cast was on stage, and they sort of slowly turned and went, "You doing Hamlet?" And I found my way back in and got off, luckily, finally. And the director said, laughter, she goes, "Did I hear a little bit of Hamlet tonight?" I said, "Well, I see you're doing it next season. I thought I'd get an early audition."
How do we meet?
We did A Month in the Country with Helen Mirren and F. Murray Abraham and Ron Rifkin. And we had shared a dressing room. So I saw him in his underwear. And we became good friends ever since.
We have a bond because of the Parkinson's, definitely. And working on this project has brought us together, too.
Yeah. The idea for us is to do a performance, one performance only, one night only, to rehearse for 4 or 5 weeks and put up...
Samuel Beckett's Endgame.
Put up the play. Tie it into our daily lives.
Our daily lives and the whole aspect of the disease of Parkinson's. So it's not just about the play. It's not just about our lives and our families. It's not just about the world of this disease. It's about all of that stuff.
Right. Well, the reason we're doing Endgame, I think...
It's the perfect play.
Yeah, it just dovetails into our particular strengths and weaknesses right now. As I was reading Ham, I just felt like, this guy is like talking about my life here, about Parkinson's. And that's what it really felt like, especially when he got to the word, "Have you not had enough?" And Chloe says, "Yes, of what?" And I go, "Of this thing." And I thought, Parkinson's, fuck. And I thought, the room, they're locked in this room. I thought, oh, Parkinson's. You know, I thought, one guy can walk, one guy can't. Parkinson's, you know.
When Dan called me up and said, "How would you like to work on this material?" I said, "Yes." And the fact that it dovetails perfectly with the symptoms of our Parkinson's doesn't hurt the matter at all. What do they do while they're waiting for the end? What do they do?
Yeah,
they perform!
Yeah. Yeah.
And I think that's sort of what we do. Two actors with diminishing physical abilities playing two characters with diminishing physical abilities, trying to get through the last stages of their lives.